Hey Pythoneers, ever faced the challenge of processing massive log files? In this video, I'll show you how Python generators make handling large files more efficient, line by line. Let's dive in. Working with large log files can be slow and memory intensive. But there's a better way. Generators. They save memory by generating values on the fly, so you don't have to load the entire file at once. If you're new to generators or want a deeper understanding, check out my dedicated video all about how Python generators work. Now let's jump into the code and create a log file generator. First, we define a function called readLargeFile with a file path as input parameter. Then we open using the with open as syntax. Inside, we run a for loop that runs through every line in the file and then yields it. Simple, right? We will work with a very large log file in this example, which I have already loaded into the project. Inside, you will find unstructured log messages. We add this code to visualize the first 500 rows, but why should we use a generator here? Generators are memory efficient because they generate values as needed rather than storing the entire file in memory. This makes them ideal for large files. Let's see this generator in action. Here's how you can use it to process each line of a log file and perform some analysis. With the data from the log file, you can perform various analyses, such as error analysis, identify errors or warnings to troubleshoot issues, usage tracking, monitor how often functions or services are used, security monitoring, watch for suspicious activities or unauthorized access, performance monitoring, analyze your application's or system's performance over time. Let's walk through a code example that demonstrates these four use cases. We'll utilize the generator to read lines from the log file and sort each line into a specific file based on its content. Errors will go into one file, usage logs into another, security alerts into a third, and performance data into a fourth. This way, we can easily manage and analyze the logs later. This code handles error analysis by searching for the keywords warning or error. Next, we have the usage tracking code, which looks for instances of function X called. For security monitoring, we check for unauthorized access. Finally, the performance monitoring code searches for the keyword load time. When we run the code, we get four files, each containing the corresponding log messages directed to the appropriate file. And that's it. We learned how to use Python generators to handle large log files efficiently. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe for more Python tutorials. Before you go, check out this video to keep learning. Thanks for watching, and happy coding!